News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. I'm Dan, and joining me this morning is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Dan, and hello, everyone.
So what's our story about?
Today's story is about an invitation to talk.
OK, let's hear more from this BBC World Service news report.
After weeks of anti-government protests in Hong Kong, the territory's leader, Carrie Lam, has said she wants to listen to what people have to say. Demonstrations against creeping Chinese mainland influence over Hong Kong have escalated since mid-June.
So there has been protest in Hong Kong for the last 11 weeks. Now, some of these protests have got quite violent. This most recent protest was actually peaceful. Carrie Lam, who is the chief executive of Hong Kong, has announced the establishment of a platform for dialogue to listen to what people want to say. So there's going to be a mechanism for communication between Carrie Lam and the protesters.
OK. And we've got three words and expressions that our viewers can use to talk about this story. What do we have for them?
We have shuns, olive branch and concessions.
Shuns, olive branch and concessions. OK, can we have our first headline, please?
We can. So we're going to look at Al Jazeera first. Hong Kong's Carrie Lam offers talks but shuns protesters' demands.
Shuns, deliberately ignores, avoids or rejects something. Now, this is a verb, if I'm not mistaken.
This is a verb. S-H-U-N is the base verb. It's a regular verb, so shunned, shunned. It take with a double N. It does take an object, so you shun something.
I can't say I shun.
You can't say I shun. You need to say what you're shunning.
Okay, so how does it work?
Well, shun has a similar meaning to avoid or ignore or reject. It's when something is bad, negative, unpleasant, you don't like it, you don't want to be around it. So when you see it, you avoid it.
Ah, a bit like plastic at the moment with, you know, the environmental movement and society. We're being encouraged to shun plastic.
A lot of people are shunning plastic. They're avoiding using plastic as much as possible, yes.
Okay, so obviously plastic is a thing. Do we only shun things?
No, you can shun people. In fact, it's more used for people, really. You can shun people that are negative in some way. You might have, if you play a sport, there might be somebody on the team or on your side or the other side who plays too aggressively, who breaks the rules, who isn't very pleasant. You will shun them. You'll avoid socialising with them. You'll avoid talking to them, avoid playing
in their team. Shun that kind of behaviour as well.
Shun the behaviour indeed, yes, as well as the person, you shun the behaviour. So it's used as a way of saying you avoid something because it's bad in some way.
I also heard that you use it a lot in the passive, don't you? People are shunned.
Yes, very much so. You can say somebody who is a thief, for example, they might be shunned by their community. They might be shunned by their neighbours or just they're shunned.
Let's go to our second headline, please.
So this time we're going to time. The headline is a platform for dialogue. Hong Kong's leader promises to listen to a community torn apart by protest. Now, our phrase today is actually in the first line of the story. Carrie Lam, Hong Kong's embattled top official, held out an olive branch to anti-government protesters.
Olive branch. Action taken as an attempt to end a disagreement. Now, I'm guessing that she didn't actually hold out a stick with olives on it.
No, she didn't. An olive branch, O-L-I-V-E and B-R-A-N-C-H. Olives are those like fruits that you eat often with salad or sometimes you cook with them. You can put them in drinks sometimes, either black or green, small with a fruit.
Do you like them?
I love an olive.
I can't stand them.
Yeah, it's a bit, people either love them or hate them. Mm. I love them, especially the black ones. They grow on trees. And there's actually a biblical reference here. If you know your Bible or Old Testament stories, Noah, who was on the ark with the flood and all the animals in his ark, he sent out a dove to see if there was any land anywhere. The dove came back and it was carrying a branch of the olive tree. And this is a symbol of peace. The dove is a symbol of peace. It's a symbol of new beginnings. So if you hold out an olive branch, you don't literally hold out a stick with
leaves on it. We would all be carrying olive branches everywhere, wouldn't we? You'd have to carry two bags, one for your normal stuff and one for all your olive branches.
So because of the inconvenience of having to carry olive branches with you everywhere, we use it figuratively or idiomatically. If you hold out an olive branch, you do something that makes to symbolize the fact that you want to reconcile, you want to make peace, you want to move ahead, you want to make friends again after a disagreement.
It's interesting that you said hold out an olive branch. So I'm guessing that's one of the common verbs that we use with it.
It's a very strong collocation. To hold out an olive branch means to do something to signal that you want to make friends with somebody. You can also extend an olive branch. You can offer an olive branch.
Like,
to someone.
Like I did with Rob, again. I mean, Rob and I had a disagreement over a script. It was nothing to do with biscuits. But knowing that Rob likes biscuits, after our fight, I bought him a cookie as an olive branch.
Oh, did he accept your offer of an olive branch?
He did. I held out an olive branch to him by buying him a cookie, and he gobbled it up.
Never fails, does it, the cookies? No.
Right, let's move to our third and final headline. But before we do, did you know that this is not the first time that News Review has covered events in Hong Kong? No, we recently covered them, didn't we, Catherine?
We did. So if you click in the link under the video, you'll be able to go to another episode of News Review about this story and learn some more vocabulary related to it.
Fantastic. Okay, let's go to our third and final headline then, please.
All right, so we're looking at Hong Kong Free Press. Hong Kong leader promises open, direct dialogue, offers no concessions to protesters' demands.
Concessions. Something given to reach an agreement. Verb?
The verb is actually concede. Concessions, spelled C-O-N-C-E-S-S-I-O-N-S. Concessions is a noun. It's countable noun, so you can have a single concession or you can have more than one. So you'd say concessions with an S. Yes, a concession is something that you do in order to make an agreement, something that you give to the person you're disagreeing with.
Okay, so we're kind of talking about like a negotiation here, and you give something to make them feel better.
Absolutely, yes. It's kind of different to a compromise. In a compromise, you both meet in the middle, but in a concession, you give something that you didn't want to give, but it's worth it because you'll get a benefit by making an agreement.
Okay, so what verbs do we use with concession?
We often say you make a concession to somebody. You can give a concession. You can grant a concession. If you're receiving this benefit, you can say that you obtain a concession, you secure a concession, or you win a concession.
Okay. So this might work in a business sense, mightn't it? With staff the company management and the staff.
Yeah, most definitely, yes. So we see it in politics and we see it in a kind of formal context. So you've got, for example, in the business context, the staff want a pay rise, they want however much, they're going on strike. The company goes, okay, we're not going to give you everything, but we're going to give you something, and we're going to give you longer lunch breaks. We might have an extra holiday and those things to make them come back to work. They say, okay, then that'll do. We're coming back. Those benefits they've given, the extra lunch breaks, the holidays, they are concessions.
So the company made a pay concession, for example, to its staff.
And the staff accepted the concession and everybody was happy.
Or, as my mother used to say, you can't be in a relationship without making concessions.
Very wise, Mum. Yeah. You have.
So hang on a minute. One other thing. When I'm at the cinema, I do like going to the cinema. When I'm at the cinema, I see the price board, adults, children, concessions.
Concessions.
So that's not about disagreement. I'm not disagreeing with the cinema. What's going on?
No, but they are giving you something because they want you to come to their cinema. And the reason they're giving you something is because you're either, the person who gets a concession is either old or young or disabled.
Or a student.
Unemployed. Mm. It's where it's a little bit cheaper because of your personal circumstances. So you'll see concessions written. You might talk about a concessionary ticket, which is the adjective form. Concessionary bus pass. And it's when it's cheaper because you're old, young, student, disabled, unemployed, those kind, retired.
Gosh, what a useful word.
It is.
Right, let's recap our vocabulary, shall we?
Yes, so we have shuns, deliberately ignores, avoids or rejects something. Olive branch, action taken as an attempt to end a disagreement. And concessions, something given to reach an agreement.
Thank you very much. Now, if you'd like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, you won't have to make concessions. Just go to our website at bbclearningenglish.com. Don't forget, we're also everywhere on social media, so Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube. Don't shun us there. And finally, download our app because it's free and you can take us with you everywhere you go. Thank you very much for joining us and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.
Hi everyone, we hope you enjoyed that video and thank you very much for watching. We have so many more just like it, so if you don't want to miss a single one, make sure to subscribe and we will see you regularly. Hope to see you soon. Bye guys.